Hello logic lovers, this is our very first video of Next.js React Fundamental tutorial series. In this video, we will learn how to set up an IDE for better coding experience. We will use Visual Studio Code. Then we will learn how to install Next.js and all its dependencies, which is only one, and it's called Node.js. Then we will also customize our VS Code editor and install required plugins, and at the end we will launch our very first Next app. I hope you are excited because I am pumped up. So without further ado, let's get started.
Go to Google and type Visual Studio Code. The first link that pops up, just click on it. It will take you to Visual Studio Code's website. Hopefully it will detect which operating system you are on. I'm using Windows. You could be using a Mac. You could be using Linux. Doesn't matter. You can download this Visual Studio Code and install it on your machine. Once you do that, you're gonna end up to something like this. Your Visual Studio might look a little different than mine, but it's okay, there's nothing to worry. And probably yours is looking something like this. If you want, you can keep it this way. If you like the dark theme, I prefer light theme, therefore I switch back to light. But I've also realized that for recording purpose, for tutorial purpose, it's better to put it in a dark theme. So I'm gonna use the dark theme here. There's one plugin that I'm going to use during the tutorial, and that would be prettiest. What you need to do is click on this button, extensions, and search for prettiest, PRETTIER. You should find something like this. Click on it and click install. I've already installed it, therefore I don't see the install button here, but you should install it. And yeah, that's about it. So once you are done with it, we are pretty much ready to go. The second installation that we would like to do is installing Next, of course. So again, go to Google and we will search for Next.js installation. The way I have designed this tutorial is I'm going to build it not in a lecture way, but in a way that I would normally proceed for any project. So I'm going to use a lot of Google. I'm going to go through a lot of documentation, and you're going to do that with me so that you understand the journey. Okay, perfect. So we're going to jump to Next.js, and it says there's only two things required. The first is Node and one of the operating systems. So what we're going to do, we're going to first install Node. So click on this button. You will land up to Node.js, which obviously, or let's say hopefully, will detect on which operating system you are, and then you download the latest version. Download it, install it, and once you have installed it, we're going to test it. So the way you test Node.js would be open a command prompt and say node minus minus version. And you should see something like this. If you see something like this, that means you have installed Node correctly. So that one thing is out of the window. And let's look how to install Next.js. Perfect. So the way we install Next.js is super simple. You just need to copy this command and paste it in your command window. But we're not going to use this. We're going to use this one, where we will use Next.js with TypeScript. If you don't know what TypeScript means, it's super simple. Go to Google and search for TypeScript, and you'll find something like this. So TypeScript is basically JavaScript, but with more advanced syntax typing. So, you know, for example, when you use Python, you type some class, and then you put a dot, and then you see a list of all the methods that are on that class. So that's what TypeScript enables you to do in JavaScript. So it's easier. It's a strongly typed programming language that you can build on JavaScript. It helps you fix your code while you are, you know, coding. So yeah, what we're gonna do is we're gonna go back to Next.js and copy this command. One thing that I always recommend people is always select a folder where you want your project to, let's say, reside, basically. So I'm going to select a folder for myself where I'm going to put all my data, all my training related excuse me, all my training related materials. So I'm going to say TTS. I created a folder, and here I'll click on this address bar and I'll type cmd and press enter. What this does is it creates a command window for me in the same location. If you want, you can open a normal window and you can just simply go through it. You can do a cd command and navigate to that folder. Anyway, since we are already in the folder, I'm gonna just copy paste what we copied from Next.js website. Sorry, with this one, what this does is it tells Next.js to create a project with TypeScript enabled. That's all it does. You don't have to do anything special. So we're gonna press enter. Going to ask you a couple of questions and just say yes and give it a name, and this should be okay. So it's asking you a project name. I'm going to say TTS text to speech tutorial. Okay, project cannot have capital names, which is fine. TTS tutorial. I can type tutorial. Press enter. It's gonna download all the dependencies, and I'm gonna come back once everything is downloaded and set up.
All right, everything is installed and everything looks good. We're gonna test our first Next.js project. And you can do it the way you see it on the screen. What you need to do is just go to this folder, so cd tts, and just use the command that is displayed on your window. So npm run dev, press enter. What this will do, it will spin up a localhost server for you, and then you can basically go to your browser and you can see if all the installation was correct and everything is working the way it should. So if I go here on my Chrome browser and I click on and I type localhost 3000, you see that I get this welcome to Next.js. And that's what basically you need. If you're able to see this window, you have done great job. I think from this point onwards, not gonna use command window. So I'm gonna press Control C to terminate this batch job. And once I terminate this batch job, I'm gonna open this project in Visual Studio that we installed earlier.
All right, logic lovers, that's all for this video. In the next one, we will learn how to use VS Code for our Next.js app, and we will understand the default files provided to us when we created that Next.js app. See you there. And before you click on the next video, do not forget to subscribe and like the video. It motivates me to create more videos for you. Also,
You can use the comment section to let me know what other things you would like to learn, and I will create that tutorial for you.